Ating mga kaaway, tayo ay kanyang iniligtas. Bilang Panginoon, awit ang kalalakas. At tutugin ang kita, at ang kaya ng biya.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, we call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I could not talk to you as a spiritual people, but as fleshly people, as infants in Christ. I fed you milk, not solid food, because you were unable to take it. Indeed, you are still not able even now. For you are still of the flesh. While there is jealousy and rivalry among you, are you not of the flesh and walking according to the manner of man? Whenever someone says, I belong to Paul, and another, I belong to Apollos, are you not merely men? What is Apollos after all, and what is Paul? Ministers through whom you became believers, just as the Lord assigned each one. I planted, Apollos watered, but God caused the growth. Therefore, neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who causes the growth. He who plants and he who waters are one, and each will receive wages in proportion to his labor. For we are God's co-workers. You are God's field, God's building. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Blessed the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance. From heaven the Lord looks down, he sees all mankind.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
From his fixed throne he beholds all who dwell on the earth. He who fashioned the heart of each, he who knows all their works.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and who our shield. For in him our hearts rejoice, in his holy name we trust.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own. Please all stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After Jesus left the synagogue, he entered the house of Simon. Simon's mother-in-law was afflicted with a severe fever, and they interceded with him about her. He stood over her, rebuked the fever, and it left her. She got up immediately and waited on them. At sunset, all who had people sick with various diseases brought them to him. He laid his hands on each of them and cured them. And demons also came out from many, shouting, "You are the Son of God." But he rebuked them and did not allow them to speak, because they knew that he was the Christ. At daybreak, Jesus left and went to a deserted place. The crowds went looking for him, and when they came to him, they tried to prevent him from leaving them. But he said to them, "To the other towns also, I must proclaim the good news of the kingdom of God, because for this purpose I have been sent." And he was preaching in the synagogues of Judea. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
The Gospel gave us a bird's eye view of what Jesus was doing in a single day. Ano ang ginagawa ni Jesus kada araw? Kaya dito malalaman natin yung mga gawain ng ating Panginoon ginuguhit ng ating Ebanghelyo. Curing the sick, like Simon Peter's mother-in-law. Driving out demons. Teaching in the synagogues, preaching by the hillside, by the byroads, complying with his social obligations here and there. In the version of today's event in scriptures, according to Mark's gospel, there Mark will comment that the whole town of Capernaum was at the door of the house where Jesus was. Ang buong bayan nagkatipon mismo, no? Doon sa pintuan ng tahanan kung saan ang ating Panginoon nakatira. And so if we talk about being very busy, if this is what Jesus was doing daily, nobody can compare with the Lord. Pwedeng sabihin natin matrabaho yung ating Panginoon, halos wala na siyang panahon kumain. If you look at the timetable, this was in the morning, the time when our Lord was at Simon Peter's house. And then the narrative goes on to telling us about what he did by sunset. And then the next day at daybreak. Kaya mapapansin natin, halos wala nang pahinga yung ating Panginoon. In fact, his own relatives will complain about him, saying that he is out of his mind. Hindi na nakakain, baka hindi na nakatulog. And based on our standards, based on our experiences, our Lord must be stressed out. But he was not. In fact, he was at peace. Ano ang sikreto ng Panginoon? It is found in today's gospel, partially found in today's gospel, where it says, rising very early before dawn, he left and went off to a deserted place. But a detail is provided us by Mark in his gospel. Because our Lord, waking up early at daybreak, went to a deserted place in order to pray. Nananalangin siya. nakipagsalitaan siya sa kaniyang tatay sa isang puok, sabihin natin sa isang ilang. So we find our Lord in that particular deserted place where He prayed and conversed with His Father. Sometimes when we look at our own lives, no, we find ourselves anxious. Daming mga bagay, pangyayaring, bumabahala, nakakabalisa, nagbibigay ligalig sa ating buhay. Halimbawa, sa araw na ito, magtatanong tayo, babaha ba? I-suspend ba yung trabaho? Suspended na nga yung klase. And for the last 3 days, yun ang nangyayari, hindi po ba? Yung iba hindi nga makapasok, kahit kailangang pumasok dahil sa baha. So this is what we find ourselves in. Almost every day, we tend to complain. We tend to be depressed. We are stressed out. Ika nga. And so, when we hear of pessimism in our lives, complaints, we look at the scriptures. We try to find answers. In the Old Testament, there is a book that lists complaints, and that is the book of Job, kung saan etong si Job, ang dami niyang reklamo sa Panginoon. But when we look at it, Job is relatable to us because we also have many complaints. And some of our complaints are a sign of our honesty and depth of our relationship with God. And since God has given us this freedom, it would be foolish for us not to embrace it. Kung tayo may reklamo, eh sabihin natin, panggitin pud natin. So if you look at your life and find there is only happiness, there is joy, yung ating kalusugan, maganda, yung ating mag-anak, matatag, yung ating mga relasyon, nagbibigay buhay sa atin, eh di magpasalamat tayo sa Panginoon. Itaas siguro natin yung ating mga kamay, and then we would shout out, praise the Lord, God is so good. Di po ba? But if you know there is anger, there is anxiety in your life, if you are carrying a hurt that you cannot find a way to put it down, if you have doubts about life, if you have fear about your future, if there is in your heart an emptiness about the future, emptiness that you are afraid to express even to yourself, don't hold it in. Don't hold it in. Don't be ceremonial. Don't stand on ceremony. Do not be polite. Ibig sabihin, lahat ng mga reklamo natin, hinaing. Lahat ng ating mga ligalig, mga suliranin sa buhay, dalhin ho natin yan sa Diyos. Let's bring our pleadings, let's bring our request to the Lord. We give Him our anger, we give Him our hurt, we bring to Him our anxiety, our doubts, our emptiness, and we say who we really are, what we really think, what we really need, how we really feel. Because I can assure you that whatever we say, God will not be surprised, He will not be offended. For whatever we can dish out at God, God is big enough to handle. Yan ang payo ni San Pedro, yan ang payo ni San Pablo. Kung meron tayong mga kahilingan sa Diyos, suliranin sa ating buhay, ibigay natin sa Panginoon at ating ilagay doon sa Kanyang paanan, so that He can give us providence, provide us with providence, and in that way, we would be helped. Of course, if we can pray with this kind of honesty, it will change us. But in order to be changed, we must come before the Lord as the people we really are. When we give to God our anger, God will heal us. When we give to God our doubts and emptiness, He will fill them. And when we complain to the Lord that we are desperate and without hope, we can always unlock the door for healing. Baunin natin yung sinabi ng ating Panginoon sa isa pang eksena sa Ebanghelyo. Ang sabi niya, "Come to me, all you who labor and find life burdensome, and I will give you rest. I will give you refreshment. For my yoke is easy, my burden is light."
Please stand.
Like the people who brought to Jesus all who were sick or possessed by demons, we bring before our Heavenly Father all who are filled with pain and sorrow and in need of healing love. Our reply, Divine Physician, heal us.
Divine Physician, heal us.
That the Church may seek to free persons from whatever stands in the way of communicating the gospel to men and women of our time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Divine Physician, heal us.
That the Lord may give hope and encouragement to the starving of the world who are unjustly deprived of food, clothing, or freedom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Divine Physician, heal us.
That those who suffer from depression and anxiety may find in Christ a sure anchor as the way, the truth, and the life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Divine Physician, heal us.
That those suffering through illness, for whom life has become an intolerable burden, may see meaning in their trials. Let us pray to the Lord.
Divine Physician, heal us.
That the dead and those who mourn may have hope in the resurrection of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Divine Physician, heal us.
Almighty Father, watch over your family, protect us, and keep us in your care, for all our hope is in you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Friends, pray that your and my sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Heavenly Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, his death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
We pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accord with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We offer each other the sign of peace. Magandang tanghali, magandang buhay sa inyo po.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
The divine physician, wounded healer, is Jesus himself, Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Now blessed are those invited to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Here I am.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Pinagpala, ilikha, ipinagpala.